Hello everyone, welcome back. For those who have been with me in this journey, welcome. Thank you so much for coming back. And for those new people who haven't subscribed, please do so. Welcome to this channel. This is the channel I talk about the cultural differences. As a native of Zimbabwe who have lived in the United States for many, many years, I talk about the cultural difference and on my own cultural shock that I have faced. Today, I'm going to talk to you about the culture in our own environment. I was observing, moving around, and I'm seeing lots of flowers and trees and just blooming, so beautiful mango trees. There's mango trees here, just regular flowers in the bushes. You are finding all these beautiful colors coming up, yellow, pink, white, all different colors of flowers just blooming up, and also the fruits, they are really coming up. You see these buds bringing up all these nice beautiful fruits that's coming. And I was thinking about the culture in our own inhabitants, in our own environment, and how that culture there shapes us as a human species. People, we are shaped by our own environment that we live in. For example, if people, they grew up where it's dry and there's no water, or it's cold and, you know, or it's wet all the time, they tend to eat different food, they tend to dress differently, they tend to maybe to stay inside more if it is cold places. Right now, as I'm talking about the flowers blooming and trees budding and all that. But in many parts of America right now, for example, Minneapolis, North, South Dakota, maybe the New York area, Wisconsin, all those places, they don't have this story that I'm talking about, you know, the budding of flowers, and all the trees are like sucked up and they are dry, and they don't have this experience that we are having here. And naturally, since we are having this experience right here, it's going to make us act and do things differently. Even our way of eating is going to be different. Our way of dressing is going to be different. Even in talking, have you ever talked to a person who is feeling cold? You know, they seem like they are shaking and they are, you know, they're not comfortable. They're not comfortable in that way as they are talking to you, because they are just so cold and they're tense. So these things, they shape us. So going to my own culture as a native of Zimbabwe, I have seen so many things that, you know, that shapes us as a people. For example, we tend to be a little bit slower in things that we do when we do things. And it really just sometimes affects people. When I go home now, I feel like I face this like a reversal of cultural shock, because when I go into a restaurant, people, they tend to be real slow. Their steps, everything as they are serving you, it's really slow. It's not like people who are going, you know, they bring your food to you. It's like everything is really slow. And I looked into that and thinking about this whole environment that shapes who we are. And I was thinking, you know, in this nation, or in our nation, in most parts of Africa, I would say, we don't have a culture of rushing. And when I think again, you know, we grow our food, we go and fetch water, we do this and that. Everything is like there is a time for it. If you didn't do it in the morning up to maybe 6 o'clock in the evening, maybe you're not able to do it. So after that, it's like, what's the rush? I'm not going to do it. I won't be able to do it, you know, because you can't do it. We grow our own food. Growing food, anybody who knows about when you are in the country and you're growing food, you're waiting for the rain to come. You are waiting to put your food a certain time in the ground. You're waiting for that food to start germinating and growing. And then you have to go in and you start weeding. And then you have to go back again and you do the weeding again, maybe three times weeding. And things are just growing naturally. You know, there is no like I need to rush it so it can be 3 months it's out of here or 2 months it's out of here so I can plant something else, because you cannot do it because that environment doesn't allow you to do that. So just going back to think about how people can be shaped by their environment. Here in Florida, like I say, it's warming up. It has been warming up so well. We can see people in their bikinis at the beach, walking around sleeveless. All those things that you maybe right now, if I turn on the TV or looking in somewhere in Wisconsin, maybe I might not see something like that. Why? Because it's cold. So it shapes that environment. The foods that we eat is also influenced by that particular environment or climate that we are facing, because we cannot go and drink cold stuff when it is so cold. We eat soup and different things like that. Since I came to Florida, I don't make as much soup, but in Wisconsin was like almost every day we have to have some kind of soup to warm up ourselves because it's so cold. So we had to do these things. So environment, when we look at it, it plays such a vital course in our own lifestyle. It plays a big role in our own lifestyle, plays a big role in all what we do in our life. It's not a small thing. Everything that we see really shapes us, and it brings to exactly who we are. And I just wanted everybody to think and appreciate this cultural and these differences that we face, because we cannot just, some things we cannot just change it. It's what it is, and that's how it is. So we can all just appreciate one another and learn to just be there for one another. So enjoy. Thank you so much for coming. Please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button. Share the video. We want so many people to enjoy this. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.